Hey everybody, good afternoon officially in 30 seconds. So today is day two of officially being stuck at home. I guess it's day one. So what I want to do today is I have an activity that I want to teach you that I think is really cool. It's called Zentangles. And it is something that you can easily do at home. You can have your supplies readily available. I'm sure everybody has paper and a pencil at home. And most of us have access to the internet. So first things first, in the beginning of the video, I want to talk a little bit about something that doesn't need a whole video to be discussed. I want to talk about some of the skills that people are going to want to use right now that you might not necessarily think about because we're adults. So there's a lot of adults listening right now that we have been taught that after you get out of the kid age that you can't do the things that you used to do when you were a kid. The one thing that I learned as a recreational therapist is that there are no age limits to things. If you look on a set of Play-Doh or a set of Legos, you see ages 3 and up, ages 4 and up. You don't see ages 3 to 12 as socially appropriate. Just because it's not socially appropriate to do the things that you did when you were a kid doesn't mean that you shouldn't do them. The things that I've learned is that if you do the things that you used to do when you were younger, you will actually get that feeling of nostalgia and happiness that comes with not having all of the life stressors of being an adult. So with that being said, color something. Play video games. I just charged up my 3DS and my Nintendo DS so that I could play video games because I'm stuck at home. What else are you going to do? Absolutely nothing. So play your video games. Bust out your N64 if you're lucky enough to have one. Mine's downstairs, thankfully. But do the things that you wouldn't necessarily do because you're busy with work. So something else that I mentioned is coloring. Coloring is something that I have retaught to so many different people. And what I'm learning about coloring is that people think that it's so juvenile that they won't even do it. Adult coloring is a huge thing right now, thankfully, because it's coming back around. They have a ton of coloring books available on Amazon for very cheap. You can get them for like $6. Right now, Amazon isn't delivering, unfortunately, but chances are you have something that you can color. And if you don't, go online, look on Google. They'll have pages that are readily available that you can print off. Some of these are very intricate. Some of them are less intricate. So for those of you that have trouble seeing, you can get ones that are less on the intricate side. You can get ones that are animal. Some of these are not kid appropriate. We'll just leave this one to the imagination. Those are awesome. So they're called swear word coloring books on Amazon. They're like $6, $7, but they are absolutely hilarious. You will never know the release that you can get from coloring something that says a swear word or says something that wouldn't necessarily be negative that you would want to say to someone, but you wouldn't, especially in the work environment. Or if you want to say it to the world right now because nobody likes what's going on. So yes, coloring books. Coloring has a ton of different benefits. A ton. So something specific. There are people that are dealing with different things. Some people are dealing with stress and anxiety. Some people are just dealing with boredom. If you're dealing with boredom, there's no right or wrong way to color. You do it however you want. But if you're dealing with stress and anxiety and you're looking to get something that's going to specifically distract you, what you want to do is you want to color from the outside in. You want to pick a specific color palette. And what that does is as you color around and you move more towards the center, it's going to force you to focus on the colors that you need to use next, on the specific spot that you're working on the continuous symmetric design. You're going to focus on what you're doing and doing it correctly. And what that is going to do is it is going to clear the rest of those negative thoughts out of your mind and give your mind that break from that negativity that you need to relax and calm yourself and allow yourself to think more rationally. Most of us that have that stress and anxiety, you're able to think rationally. It's just once the anxiety takes over, you're pretty much done. I have one of these on my shoulder. Mandalas is what they're called. They are absolutely awesome. If you want to look them up online, that's spelled M as in mom, A, N as in Nancy, D, A, L, A, S. So look them up. You can print them off and then use whatever you have in the house to color them, whether it's Sharpies, pencils, crayons. I'm sure we have something laying around. But think about the other things that you haven't done. If you have somebody else in your house, you can play. This has, I don't know if you can see them, the itty bitty dots. Do you remember that game where you put the squares and everybody draws a line and then when you fill in the square, you get to color it in? Games like that, tic-tac-toe. Okay, the things that bring you back to your innocence. Before we had all of this stress on our shoulders. Kids right now, they have no idea what's going on. And if they do have an idea of what's going on, they aren't naturally thinking of the worst possible scenario. They aren't thinking about the negatives. They're thinking about the positives. How awesome is it that I get to stay home all day? How awesome is it that I get to spend extra time with my parents and my animals? I have recently adopted a turtle that I found in the middle of a gravel path. His name is Gravel. And I bought a house plant. Okay? Bringing the outside in. You do what you need to do. Okay? With what you have, like I said yesterday. Another thing, quickly, that I wanted to mention is there are apps and programs that will send you positive text messages or messages of the positive nature every day. So when I was in a really crappy spot mentally, I signed up for what's called Shine Text. If you go to join.shinetext.com, it was on the Today Show. It was a big deal. You can go and sign up for text messages and they will send you a daily positive text message at a specific time. And that will allow you to get that positive message that you might need to hear that you aren't creating on your own. So it sends you things like the one that's listed on here is, you have the power over the thoughts that don't serve you. So basically, you have the power to suppress those negative thoughts. If they're not good for you, work out how to get through those thoughts. A lot of people right now are thinking, I'm not into work. What am I going to do? I have bills. I have kids. I need food. I have all this. All of those thoughts, they're not helping you. Yes, they are realistic. All of the feelings and thoughts that you're having right now are 100% valid. My biggest suggestion to you is write your thoughts down. And not necessarily in the journal form that I mentioned yesterday, but write your thoughts down in a list. And then one at a time, try and tackle a plan for that thought. I don't have the money to pay my bills. A plan for that thought would be to call your bill companies. A lot of companies right now are having programs that you can either skip payments or you can push your payments back to where they will accumulate. I think DTE is one of those companies, if I recall correctly, that if you don't have the money to pay, they're not going to shut your stuff off. But when this is all over, your bill will be whatever you didn't pay and you just get rid of that bill, kind of like a credit card. But if you don't have the money to pay the bill, you don't have the money to pay the bill. They all know what's going on in the world right now. You don't have to explain yourself. They know. All right, so without further ado, today's activity, Zentangles. I love them. I did not create them. There is a couple that did. If you go to www.zentangle.com, you can order supplies, like actual legitimate supplies, and you can see the story of the couple that created them. It was an artist and an architect, something of that nature. I can't necessarily remember, but it's awesome. So I'll show you some of the examples of some of the stuff that I have made. So this is a Zentangle. Basically, I call it organized chaos. They are repetitive designs that come together to make a really cool design. So if any of you doodle, if you're doodlers, this is basically doodling. And some of these look super, super intricate, but they're not at all. It's just a design that was in a book that I copied or that I made up. Something that I colored in. I think that's it. Yeah. So this is the one that I made the other day. And my client said, "Oh, that looks so crazy." And I showed her how you do these swirls. And she was blown away. It's just triangles. You just draw a line over and over and over until you get to the center, and it looks like some weird woven 3D thing. So there are a ton of Zentangle designs online. Let me see here. This is the one that I'm currently working on. I decided to get a little humorous with the name of coronavirus. Yes, I know it's spelled differently, but there's the bottle. And then I'm just creating random designs on the outside and then on the inside. And when this is done, it's going to look really cool. So this is an official Zentangle square. You do not need the official Zentangle square. You can use absolutely anything. In here, I also have just regular pieces of paper that I have cut out. You do not need the official square. Any paper works. So what you're going to do is you are going to take a pencil. The official Zentangle pencils are just golf pencils, so any pencil will work. So you're going to take the pencil and you're going to create yourself a border. Okay, so basically, in the simplest sense, you're going to put four dots in the corners. Okay, four dots in the corners. Now you can create the border however you want. You can do it with straight lines, squiggly lines, zigzags, more dots. You can do a swirl, however you want. I'll give you a few options. Zigzag. And this one will be lines. So, there's some different ways to create yourself a border. Now, as you can see, the border can be all the same or it can be different. This is your creativity. That's all it is. So there is no right or wrong way to do it. Create yourself a border, you're good to go. Then in the most simplest form, how I was taught, because they do have, you can go to school, go to a class to become a certified Zentangle instructor, which I am not, and you can teach other people the ways of the Zentangle. How I was taught is to start off by separating it into three different sections. So I'm gonna do that. You can also separate the sections any way you want. I chose to just do something simple. Now, once you separate the sections, that's when you want to go on Google and look up different designs. They do have books that you can buy on. These are Zen Doodle books, not Zentangle, but it's all the same thing. These are just different ideas for patterns. Some of these, this book. So it shows you a cool pattern, and then it breaks down that pattern step by step by step by step. Okay? So it makes it very, very easy to create the look that you might think is really, really stressful when you look at it, but it turns out to be really, really simple. Let me see if there's one in here. This is a great book, by the way. If you can get this on Amazon, it has a ton of different designs. Also shows you different ways to do Zentangles. You can do it in leaves, you can do it in hearts, you can do it in flowers, however you want to do it. It's very, very simple. All you gotta do is just follow what you want to do. The thing that stressed me out the most in the beginning of doing Zentangles is that you're not supposed to use an eraser. If you mess up, you're supposed to use that mess up as an opportunity to create a new design. So you're not supposed to erase it. You're supposed to just go with it. And I think that that's really great as you learn to do Zentangles, to teach yourself that if you mess up, it's not necessarily the end of the world. You just go with it and figure it out. And as adults, I'm sure that we do that more often than we realize. So yeah, these books are absolutely awesome. I'm gonna pick a design and do it for you really quickly. I don't want this to be like a super long video, and I'm new to this whole video live thing. So I'll pick one and I will show you kind of how it goes. See if I can find one that looks cool. We'll do the one that I said looked really awesome and that it ended up looking really cool. And you can do this however you want to. So I'm gonna try and draw this backwards by doing it on this camera and see how it works. All right, so. Pencil. There it is. Shoved it in the couch. So you start off by drawing a square. So if you're going to draw throughout the whole entire thing, you would want to just do kind of like a patchwork quilt pattern, and then in every square you do the same design. But I'm gonna show you in just one square because it makes it easier. So you draw the square . Okay, simple, not perfect at all. And then what you're going to do is you're gonna start in one of the corners. And you're just going to draw a line that goes almost with the corner line, but not. And when you get to the end, you do the exact same thing going to the next line. You go a little bit along the line, but a little bit out. Okay? And then you're going to do the same thing over and over, a little bit out. A little bit out, a little bit out, Now I'm doing this slowly. Hopefully it's able to be received well by you guys. But you're just drawing a little bit away from the line that you drew previously until you meet a line and then you stop. And you're going over and over and over. Now when you get to the end of this, you'll see that it's starting to look like it's spinning, which is the illusion. Little bit away, a little bit away, all the way till there's nothing left. Okay, now it looks like there's four weird growth looking things all coming together. Now, if you were to do this same thing on this section, I'm going to do it really quickly and show you what it'll look like. It doesn't matter what corner you started in, it's not going to look weird, it's going to look cool. So I guess I shouldn't have said this was triangles earlier. It's not triangles, it's squares. I feel like I should be playing the Jeopardy theme. Do, 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 do. Let's see. So many allergies. If Mother Nature would just make up her mind, I would be eternally grateful. Okay, so they start to look like they're swirling together. This looks a lot cooler when you have thin point markers. So these are micron markers. I think this is backwards to you, but sorry. But they have micron markers. Number one is the thinnest one that they have. Number five is thicker for coloring in certain spots. You can buy markers like this on Amazon. These are all colored markers, so you can add some color to it. I like to stick with the black and white. Some other tools that you can order. If you go on zentangle.com, you can see the different tools that you can order. It comes with, like, you can order the official zentangle.com golf pencils. You can order these. Let me see if I have the bag so you can see. I think I bought these at Michael's. They're called tortillons, I want to say is how it's pronounced. It's right there. T-O-R-T-I-L-L-O-N-S. There we go. That's a little better. The micron markers you can get at Michael's or probably Walmart while you're doing your essential shopping. Don't go out just for art supplies. I don't think, although your mental health should be an emergency, I don't necessarily think the government thinks it is. There's also these, which you can use to shade things. If you notice in some of my designs, let's see. Alright, so this one that I did recently, outside the edge, that's all shaded. And then inside these little snake looking things, that's shading. And it ends up looking really cool. Trying to find the one that a kid did for me. There it is. So I've done this with kids all the way from 4 up until adults that get really, really into it. This is one that a kid at the mental health facility that I worked at did for me. Her name was Tiffany. She was awesome and adorable. But she obviously didn't do as organized of a design. This is one that a friend of mine did recently that's not done yet. But as you can see, whatever design that you pick is perfectly fine. You can do lines, you can do flowers, you can do different heart designs, zigzags. That kind of looks like a window, which is cool. You can do absolutely anything. I highly suggest looking online. Just look on Google for Zentangle designs, and you'll find way more than you think that you need. And I promise you, it'll end up looking really cool. And it'll be something that you can be proud of. Don't limit yourself to separating it into 3 sections. You can separate it however you want. Back to the book again. If you notice, like in... this was the one that I did during New Year's. I just did one design. My softball was 3. The dog bone, I guess that's technically 3. But you can separate it into however many different designs that you want. So, that is Zentangles. If you have any questions or if you want any different ideas, or if you have any questions about anything that you're working on or anything that's not even remotely related to these videos, please feel free to message me personally. And I mean, I'm not doing anything because I'm stuck at home. So moral of today's video, do the things that you used to do when you were a kid and start there. You might find something that will help you get through this that you didn't think of. And after that, try Zentangles. It's cool. Tomorrow I'm going to set some stuff on fire, which is gonna look really cool and is fun to do with the kids. And then I will show you some different activities that I have laying around the house that you might like to do. I don't know if they're that easily accessible, but you might be able to get your hands on them at Walmart again while you're doing your essential grocery shopping. And then I'm going to show you an activity called quilling, paper quilling. So if you want to start Googling that, I think that's really cool and is really easy to do. Well, I hope you guys enjoyed today's video, and again, please message me, like the page if you want to see future videos, and have a good day. Stay healthy.